Okay, people of the internet, I am happy and proud and honored to let you know we have our first guest, the couple that is keeping the party vibes positive all across America. It's the creators and founders of TrapxArt, Jesse and Amina. So just for anyone who doesn't know what TrapxArt is, just give us a quick little overview and we'll get into the interview.
TrapxArt is basically a platform for artists. So we do events where artists showcase their artwork, and then we have magazines, we have fashion shows, we have a media department. So it's basically just a platform where artists can get promoted.
And people get lit.
That happens a long way.
That just happens naturally.
But yeah, we've been working for ourselves since 2011.
And now that TrapxArt is spreading beyond the Bay, how do the other cities compare to the original?
I mean, it's the same and different. Pretty much everywhere you go, you attract like people who are into art and then just that type of crowd. But then, you know, I was just in New Orleans and you could just, they got accents out there. So it's just little things like that make it different. Each city, maybe a different accent here, a different accent there. But in general, the event, they attract the same type of people.
Is there a place that you've liked as much as the Bay or more than the Bay? Or
is
like, no place?
Murals, and it just seems similar to the people in Detroit and Oakland, kind of. They're the most similar.
Yeah, I feel like with Detroit, Detroit kind of gets a bad rap. Right?
Yeah, people are like, oh, Detroit's dangerous.
Yeah,
there might be
things in Detroit too, right? Exactly. So I feel like people in Detroit and Oakland kind of have something to prove, you know, where it's like, no, like we come out, we're positive, we have art, we're creative, like we're not all, like, you know, but people make us seem.
Right.
So I feel like Detroit has a lot of pride in our city,
yeah.
And Oakland has a lot of pride. We have a lot of pride in our city, so I feel like that's but we love all the other cities.
Yeah,
we're
gonna go visit Detroit then.
Yeah,
for sure.
I would
definitely want to go. I would recommend it. It's dope. It's very dope.
Okay, so being the married one of the group, I have to ask, what's it like working with your spouse?
It's cool. I mean, it's cool because I think when a lot of people are, you know, you're in a relationship or you're married and you have two totally different career paths going on, a lot of times, you know, you get home and you're frustrated about something, you want to talk about something, your spouse is like, all right, I'm sure, yeah. Right, you know, but I feel like since we're kind of experiencing everything together, you know, we're in this together, like, literally all the time, which, you know, it's, you know, we bump heads occasionally.
Yeah, we bump, but just like anybody,
yeah.
But yeah, I definitely think, it's been positive because, you know, we can always bounce ideas off each other.
Even if it's at 3 a.m.
Yep. It's literally happened before, so.
Yeah, so that's the part I think is positive. And, you know, like anything, you'll bump heads, but, you know, I think it's, without her, it wouldn't be a trap art. Without me, it wouldn't be a trap art. So, you know, it's like building something together.
Well, that's good. That means that you guys good relationship as your business is successful too, right? Relationship goes for y'all. What has been like your favorite collaboration that you guys have created at a trap bar?
I really like fashion.
Fashion.
So we started the fashion last year, and we've had maybe like four or five fashion shows so far. So a lot of times, you know, we work with, on the most basic level, like we'll work with a vendor who'll come in and just like set up, you know, set up to She's one of our designers in our next fashion show coming up. She's making like crochet swimsuits and everything all by hand and stuff. So yeah, I think the fashion has been amazing. It just kind of creates a family vibe beyond just us.
So which of the TrapxArt projects has been your favorite outside of the fashion?
Probably the magazine. Mm-hmm. It's pretty dope. It's fun to like put something together with other people. So, you know, we have a photographer, Jay Short, who's pretty much done the majority of the photography in the magazine. My cousin, Bia Mechie, he orchestrates all the behind the scenes stuff, but then just doing photo shoots and interviews with different artists involved in trap art has been fun. It's just building with each other, so it's been pretty fun.
Yeah, and for the magazine, when I was in college, I was a communication major. So I actually really wanted to go to the Columbia School of Journalism. I didn't get it, right? So
they're lost.
Right. So you know, years passed or whatever, and we're doing TrapxArt and we started, decided to do the magazine, and so I learned how to format and create the whole magazine and like design it. And so I'm like thinking back, like, wow, I wanted to do, journalism. Now I have my own magazine, so
just did it.
That was it touches me like in a little special way when I see it. When we were able to create.
You are in production.
You're published.
And we've done 5, so this is the 5th version. So,
what's next for TrapxArt?
Literally next week we have the Trapathon, so that's at the biggest venue we've ever done. But other than that, just keep on doing the same type of thing. Keep on doing events and just keep on working with all the people involved.
So tell the people, when's Trapathon, where is it, where can they get tickets?
Yeah, it's Saturday, July 28th at the Cranway Pavilion in Richmond. Tickets are available at TrapxArt.com. And it's exciting. We have a lot of stuff lined up. There are 25 music performers, 16 fashion designers, hundreds of artists. That'll be showcasing vendors, there'll be food and drinks, and just lots of dope vibes in the building. So the event starts at 2 p.m., goes till 2 a.m., so we're really excited to do this. It's been a lot of work.
Imagine,
so
you're stressed out,
yeah.
Anxious, excited.
Yeah, I feel like, I'm anxious before almost every event.
Yeah, this one's a little
extra. Yeah, but this one is extra. But definitely anxious, but excited too. Just ready to see what happens.
Work out just fine.
Yeah.
Always does.
So last but not least, we're hella real. We gotta ask y'all what your hella what?
Oh, we talked about that.
Long discussion.
And the thing that we just came up with the most is like,